you having fun. Hold on.
We do have some modern tools that are used that the railroaders did not have. For instance, we have to keep very careful track of how hot that tire is. And for that, we have a little infrared sensor. Same kind of thing, if you ever watch a NASCAR race and they're checking how hot the tires have gotten after a run, exactly the same thing. Gives you a very quick spot reading. And you have to be very careful, you don't want to get the tire too hot. If you get it too hot, you actually change the way the steel behaves. Occasionally, you do have axles that go bad, or you may have a smoked wheel or a solid wheel that is so worn or damaged that you can't use it anymore. So, in addition to being able to replace tires, you also have to be able to replace axles or entire wheels. And to do that, that is done with something called a wheel press, which is the next step. So, follow me, please. To put the correct surface back on and the correct contours, correct profile, that's what I'm looking for, profile. If they get too thin, then you need to replace them. To replace them, you need to have a wheel press, because you've got to be able to take that wheel off of the axle, which is this piece. And that can take anywhere from 300 to 600 tons of force. This particular machine, this is another one that, if you had been here a year ago, it was a really, really big, very effective paperweight. It didn't work. This was rebuilt by our people and also some people from the Defense Logistics Agency. Did a very good job. And it's, like most of the machinery back here, it's a neat combination of old and new. For instance, the gray box right here, this is a motor control box for the electric motor. And this is actually a crusher box. I'm just learning some of this stuff myself, because we haven't used this before. It's been too many times. The motor is a very, very heavy-duty motor, the kind of motor that you would use in rock crushers. The little gray box is a variable frequency switcher, so that it can change the frequency of electricity going in, so you can change the speed of your motor. The electric motor, through reduction gearing, drives a hydraulic pump. Hydraulic pumps can produce up to, give or take, 600 tons of force. Now the black box, right up here, is the pressure recorder. They're not going to be using that today because they're actually going to be taking the wheel off of the axle. If you're taking the wheel off of the axle, what can happen is things will start nothing happens, and then it suddenly slips, which would produce enough of a shock that it would probably damage the recorder. That recorder is used when you're putting a wheel onto an axle. That way you can make sure that there's a nice smooth pressure gradient, no grabbing on the inside, nothing moving to the side. And that when they put a new wheel on, they actually have to keep that tape. But now Mike is going to show us how this machine works, and if you're short, step to the front. I'm sorry, not short. If you're vertically challenged, step to the front. If you're tall, step to the back.
Thank you.
wonderfully at these.
Play basketball in school. At least it's cool in here. Be a little louder.
That's why I kind of try to move a lot. At least in the east, don't see itself like that.
We have to wait on long anyway, so there's no hurry. Then it takes a while to walk all the way back over there to the car. Is it water?
I've been back to the car with it.
This is cool. Glad we decided to walk in here.
No, I see what you're saying.
Okay, Paula? No. Hard to go. What's her name?
S. Andaman. S. Andaman.
Hi, S. Andaman.
Maybe her name is Sally. Whatever, it starts with S. I think it's Sarah.
Oh, it feels good in here.
I'm hoping that this was
perfect. Where we go?
Okay.
Never heard of
it.
Thanks, guys. Hi, how we doing today?
Thank you.